Hello everyone, I hope you all are fit and fine. I, Priyanka Bisht, your accountancy teacher from Arden Progressive School, welcomes you all in your new session and in your new class, that is grade 12. So before delivering the lecture on the topic of accountancy, I would like to introduce you the syllabus of accountancy. So the syllabus of accountancy is divided into two parts. First is volume 1, second is volume 2. So volume 1 consists of two units. First, not for profit organization, and second unit is accounting for partnership, whereas volume 2 consists of two units. First is company accounts and second is analysis of financial statements. So we'll be starting with the volume 1, chapter 2, or we can say unit 2, which is accounting for partnership. So starting with the second unit of volume 1, which is accounting for partnership, this unit consists of four topics. First is basic concept of partnership. Second is admission of a partner. Third is retirement or death of a partner. And fourth is dissolution of partnership firm. So these are the four topics which we will be learning in the second unit. So in this session, we'll be starting with the first topic, which is basic concept of partnership. Now before going through the topic, we will first understand what partnership is. As we know, in the previous class, we have studied about the different forms of business organization. We know there are various types of business organizations such as sole proprietorship firm, partnership firm, company form of business, cooperative societies, etc. So if we talk about sole proprietorship concern, we know this is the organization which is controlled and managed by a sole owner, which means here in this business organization, there is only one owner. So, but there are various limitations of a sole trading concern, as only one man invests the capital, he undertakes the risk involved in the business, and he also manages the whole affair of the business. So to overcome this limitation, there is another form of business organization, which is partnership. As we know, in a sole trading concern, one man capital contributing skills, his controlling skills and his risk bearing capacity is very limited. So in partnership form of business organization, two or more person may combine, they may form an agreement, and in this way they can form a partnership firm. So partnership is basically the relation between two or more person which is based on trust and faith. Now, if we talk about the definition of partnership, so according to section 4 of Indian Partnership Act 1932. This is very important. Indian Partnership Act was enacted in the year 1932. So according to Indian Partnership Act, definition of partnership is partnership is the relation between two or more persons who have agreed to share the profits of the business carried on by all or any of them acting for all. So this is a definition of partnership under Partnership Act 1932, which is partnership is the relation between two or more persons. That means minimum two persons are required to form partnership. It is the relation between two or more persons who have agreed to share the profits of the business, which means there must be sharing of profits among the partners in the partnership firm. So here the partner shares the profits of the business carried on by all or any of them acting for all. We will understand this definition more clearly after discussing the characteristics of partnership. So starting with the characteristics of partnership, first characteristic is association of two or more persons. So association of two or more persons means that there must be at least two persons to form partnership firm. So partnership firm requires minimum two persons. Second is Partnership Act does not specify the maximum number of partners. As minimum number of person is two, maximum is not specified by Partnership Act, but Section 464 of Companies Act 2013, it restricts the maximum number of partners to 50. So Partnership Act does not specify the maximum number of partners, but Companies Act, which was enacted in the year 2013, it specified that the maximum number of partners in a partnership firm should not exceed 50. So here Partnership Act does not specify the maximum number of persons which are needed in a partnership firm, but Companies Act 2013 specify that the maximum number of partners in a partnership firm should be 50. This number should not exceed 50 number of partners. Next is all the persons in partnership firm should be competent to act. All the persons who are partners in a partnership firm should be competent to act. Competent to act means the partner should not be minor. Minor means he should not be less than 18 years. Second, the partner should not be of unsound mind. Unsound mind means he should not be mentally disturbed or retarded. Third is the partner should not be disqualified by law. So these are the three cases where the partner should be competent to act. First, he should not be minor. Second, he should not be of unsound mind. And third, he should not be disqualified by law. Now, second characteristic is agreement. What does agreement means? So here, partnership comes into existence by agreement and not by law. As in the previous class we have studied, there are various forms of business organization which comes into existence by certain law, but in case of partnership firm it does not comes by law, it comes by agreement, or it forms by agreement. Now this agreement can be oral or written. So the written agreement in accounting terms is also known as partnership deed. Written agreement is also known as partnership deed. So in this characteristic, which is agreement, agreement can be of oral or written, and existence of partnership comes by oral or written agreement. Generally partners prefer written agreement because oral agreement results into misunderstanding or disputes, and written agreement in accounting term is known as partnership deed. Now the third characteristic is existence of business and profit motive. So here partnership is formed for the purpose of carrying on some business with the intention of earning profit, and this business should be legal, which means whenever there is a partnership, the purpose of partnership should be of business nature. For example, joint ownership of some property by itself cannot be called partnership. Why? Because the purpose of joint ownership of a property is not business. Fourth characteristic is sharing of profits. As we know, partnership is a relation between two or more person who have agreed to share the profits of the business. So we can say that in partnership, the partner shares the profit among themselves in an agreed ratio or equally. So here, if any partner is deprived of his right to share the profit, it is not called partnership. So it is clear that in partnership, every partner has a right to share the profits of the business. And the last characteristic is relationship as an agent as well as principal. So in partnership, the partner is agent as well as principal. So the partner is agent as he can bind the other partners by his act, and he is principal because he himself is bounded by the act of other partners. So we have discussed all the characteristics of partnership, and or we have already concluded all the characteristics by learning the definition of partnership, which is given by Partnership Act 1932. So in this session, we have learned about the basic concept of partnership, definition of partnership under Partnership Act 1932, and also the characteristics of partnership. In the next session, we'll be continuing with some more concepts. That's all for today. Thank you.